Adjacent to the town of White Lake within North Carolina are a series of lakes which are all elongated in a northwest to southeast orientation. Yet, if we continue to search the vicinity, you will spot hundreds, perhaps even thousands, of similar depressions in the ground, the vast majority of which are not filled by lakes and are all elongated in essentially the same direction. Moving further away, you will continue to see more and more of the same features, which are surprisingly abundant in many other Atlantic coast states. These features all appear to have formed by the exact same geologic phenomena and due to first being described in the Carolinas are referred to as the Carolina Bays. In total, approximately 500,000 Carolina Bay landforms are estimated to exist across a vast stretch of land encompassing 10 states that range from Alabama and Florida all the way to New Jersey in the southeast corner of the state of New York. Because the mystery on how all these Carolina Bays formed is now more than a century old, numerous theories, some now considered absurd and debunked, with others being more plausible, have been made. These include the theory that all of the Carolina Bays were formed by a simultaneous scattered asteroid impact event, that these features were formed simply by long-term windblown erosion of sediment, or that ancient upwelling groundwater was the cause. Yet, none of these previous hypotheses appeared to fit the existing evidence. As, here is what we do know. To date, no signs of any forms of extraterrestrial impact have been discovered at any of these features. The Carolina Bays measure generally between 800 and 15,000 feet wide and between 2 and 70 feet deep, with the vast majority having a depth of no more than 15 feet. But, most importantly, dating analysis performed on sediments overlying these mysterious depressions have resulted in a large host of ages ranging from 140,000 to 11,500 years ago. So, whichever geologic process formed these estimated 500,000 features would need to fit all of the above data along with how they are all seemingly elongated in the same direction. Yet, I personally think that what the Carolina Bays are is quite easy to explain, as all of these landforms originated during the last ice age. During the most recent glacial maximum, glaciers covered large swaths of what is now the United States and Canada, including an area just north of the furthest extent north of the Carolina Bays. Adding to the fact that temperatures were much colder 20,000 years ago, all of the cold air these ice sheets created caused the Atlantic Ocean and nearshore masses of land to average below freezing for thousands of years. What I am implying is that all of these features that are now called the Carolina Bays were once a patch of permanently frozen ground known as permafrost. Over time, large masses of ice grew in the ground at small yet frequent weak points, forming what are known as ice wedges. Yet, once the glacial maximum passed, the planet slowly warmed, causing permafrost to begin thawing. This permafrost thawed first on the surface, forming small ponds of water on top of ice wedges. This melting caused the ground to subside since the same mass of ice takes up more volume than water before combining with nearby small ponds from other ice wedges forming what is known as a thermokarst lake. Some of these features subsequently filled with sediment before the vast majority of the lakes disappeared as the climate continued to warm. Thus, the Carolina Bays are remnants of thermokarst lakes which formed during the last ice age, with similar active features today being found across wide swaths of western Alaska and northern Canada. Today, there is of course no permafrost in the region between Alabama, Florida, and New York, yet these remnant depressions from the planet's last glacial period have remained. As to why these ancient thermokarst lakes formed in the same orientation, their elongated axis represents the direction of prevailing winds at the time they formed. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.